What is up, Waffle Gang? I do hope you are well. My name is Mark, and today we're checking out some more r/AmItheButthole. If you'd like to skip the initial waffle, timestamps are in the description and along the timeline below. But if you are new here, please consider hitting that like, that subscribe, maybe that notification bell too. It all helps out. And just a huge thank you from the bottom of my heart for spending 20 minutes or so with me today. It means the absolute world. And let's crack on with today's stories. Now, we're starting today's story with a story we've read before, but now has an update attached to it. So if you heard the story, always feel free to use the timestamps and let's get started. This story is from Wedding Property. Am I the arsehole for not letting my best friend have a wedding on my property after being uninvited? One of my 29 male best friends, Carla, 31 female, is getting married soon. It's only meant to be a small backyard type of wedding, but they've been planning it for a few months now and originally was supposed to be on my property. They wanted it because it's private, has lots of open space for the reception, a nice view, and the house could be used for them to get ready and stuff. Of course I said yes. She and her fiance Rick were very happy. Thing is, Carla and I do have a history. We went out on and off in college, but decided to stay friends. Then I met my wife, we got married, Carla met Rick, and now here they are. Now my wife knows I went out with Carla back in college and she didn't care. Carla still went to our wedding and everything. I never knew Rick was told or not. It's not my relationship, therefore not my business to say anything, so I never did. Rick found out recently and not in the best way. Not sure how, but from what I've heard from friends is that one mutual friend told him. No idea why, we used to date. Not only that, but apparently Carla said a couple of years ago she was still in love with me when she was already dating Rick. Don't have actual confirmation if that's exactly what he was told. All Carla's told me is that Rick was told about our past and he's angry at her for not saying anything. It became quite a drama and didn't hear from her for over a month until now. She told me they're still going to couples counseling and that the wedding is still on, but Rick requested that I not attend. It sucks, but I totally get why he wouldn't be comfortable. Then I asked the obvious question, where are they going to hold the wedding then? To my surprise, she said they still wanted it at our place. Rick said so too, and in my mind I'm going, he doesn't want the guy who dated his fiance years ago at the wedding, but still wants the wedding at his house. My wife and I are expected just to not be at our home that weekend, and I told Carla no. They're going to have to find some place else since we're not going to simply leave our home to them for the weekend. Not only for safety reasons, but it just doesn't make sense. Rick doesn't want me around because he's not comfortable, but is comfortable enough to have their wedding at my house. They really want their wedding here though, and because of that, I've been bugged by not only her, but also Rick and some friends who think I'm being a petty asshole for not letting them have the wedding here anymore. Honestly, I don't think that I am. It just doesn't make sense at all to leave your own place for a wedding we're no longer welcome to, and leaving our home totally vulnerable. Still, being accused of sabotaging their wedding, and Rick believes it's the least I can do after everything. Am I the arsehole? I'm reading that last sentence again, it brought the memory straight back of what I thought, like, the least you could do after everything. I mean, what the hell did you do? You've done nothing wrong apart from offer your place to them to begin with. It's absolutely crazy. And seeing as we covered this one before, I'll just read the one comment just to freshen it up. And this is the sort of the gist of how all the comments went, really. And it was from Pom Door, who says, Rick doesn't want to get married anymore, but doesn't want to be the bad guy breaking up with his fiance. So he's put her in an impossible position so he can get the sympathy when they split. Not the arsehole. And there was a few that was like that as well. And with that, let's just go straight to the update. I'm excited. So, update. Some stuff has happened recently and many of you wanted an update on this. Appreciate the reassurance and understanding my decision when it seems that many in this situation didn't. I remain firm in my decision about not letting them use my property for their wedding, even if they change their mind about inviting us, which honestly I don't care about anymore. Rick's family, thanks to him, got a hold of my cell, so that was more people I had to deal with. I put my foot down with Rick a few days ago and told him directly that I will go to the police and press charges for harassment. I have all the texts and calls documented. Also had a very long talk with Carla about everything going on. She apologized for it all, and she knows it's her own fault. Well, she decided to be the one to call things off in the end. Some of my friends still seem to think it's my fault, and I'm taking some distance from them for a while. and also from Carla after getting some confirmation on a few things that I needed to know. Whole thing is a mess. I'm only glad in the end that I didn't have to give in to their demands and the constant bugging has stopped. It was a huge headache over the last few days and not the kind of drama I want back in my life. Thank you to everyone who made me feel supported in this. It helped a lot not feeling like the only other person, aside from my wife, who thought their demand was insane and inappropriate. And AITA replied to this saying, wow, they ended up calling off their whole wedding. Guess they both dodged a bullet, just because you refused to be used. Good for you. Opie replied to this saying, well, Carla did, and I think she realized this was too much drama and conflict before the marriage even begins. I'm sure she had other reasons. And Katsu Random says, stay strong, man. Also, be aware of weird vendettas from Rick's family. Opie replied saying, so far, nothing in the last few days. Don't know if that's just a calm before the storm, or Rick at least warned them that I'm not playing around. And we'll have one more comment before we move on to another story. As I recall, one of the things that came out was that Carla was still in love with OP when she started dating Rick. Given what OP says about getting confirmation from Carla on some things and taking some time away from her, I imagine that was true and possibly she even still had feelings for him. If that's true, Rick's jealousy is a lot more reasonable, even as his response to it is not. And then they try getting a confirmation about Carla afterwards. And the update did get me thinking along those lines as well. Is Carla revealed her feelings for OP once again? I wonder. But what do you guys think on this one? Let me know in the comments below and we'll move on to the next story. And our next story is from C Flowers. Am I the arsehole for telling my husband my traditions matter too? And there is an update that's been added to this one, a fairly lengthy one as well. So it starts off, recently I told my husband I was going to make him a traditional style roasted salsa verde like my family made. I was super excited about this. I haven't made it since before we even started dating. Some background on this, my husband is autistic and is a cooking snob, made worse since he is a chef. 2 years ago, I told him I don't like cooking with him and refused to do it anymore because he always talked down and corrected me. He insisted it was so I could improve my technique, despite telling him that it was just fun trying things. He never comments on taste, my process if he's watching. He asked to help make the salsa, so I asked him to chop the vegetables and I would do the rest since there really isn't much. He immediately smashed the garlic, which I asked him not to, because it was easier to peel. He watched me cook a few seconds and proceeded to start a second burner and spray with butter, despite my telling him that wasn't needed. He insisted on shaking the pan to roast the veggies because it's more efficient than my turning them to roast each side, just undermining me every step. I tried to feed him a chip with the salsa when we finished and he insisted he couldn't eat as he was in work mode. I commented I thought we were just having fun, and he basically insisted he was in work mode and to give him a few minutes. I decided it wasn't worth the fight and stepped outside for a cigarette. I came back, asked if he tasted it, and he said it was good but added cream and other stuff. I got upset and told him that wasn't what I was trying to do. He said he was trying to make something good for us to snack on. I explained nothing about this was traditional anymore and that's why I was upset. And he insisted that the changes were fine, it just made it better and the process more efficient. I got upset and pointed out how traditional seemed important enough he had to come around to me not changing my name before we married. And it was good enough we spent a year going back and forth on adding my name to our future kids. Hispanic culture, kids get both last names. He got mad and said having his son carry on the family name is different than making some salsa. I told him it was more than that. He always assumed it was his way is the way we do things. And I was tired of fighting for my traditions to exist in our family. He said it was natural since we're in the US to assume we're doing things that way, since that is what the tradition is here. I told him he married a Mexican woman born in Mexico and my traditions matter too. We went back and forth and now I'm not even sure who's right anymore. And as I said, we do have an update on this one. And before we do, we'll cover a couple of the comments before we go there just to get a flavor of what's going on. Dutiful Momentum says, not the arsehole. He took over and changed your recipe, but this is also clearly not about the salsa. Best of luck to you. And the baddest Patsy says, not the arsehole, it's hard to decide if it's cultural chauvinism is worse or it's patriarchal chauvinism. In Vomitus, Rex says, "Not the arsehole, he's a chef and a self-confessed food snob, but he put fucking cream in their salsa verde. This is a sin and a crime. What a monstrosity. Obviously, as others have said, there are bigger issues in your relationship here, but I'm just horrified that anyone would bastardize salsa verde like that." And Shark Diving says, "Not the arsehole, autistic or not, he sounds like a controlling dick." And Panda Poxy says, "Not the arsehole. He's showing you that he doesn't respect you or your traditions, and that your wants will always come second to his." And Comprehensive Fun says, "Not the arsehole. Seems like this is a lot more than salsa. Have you tried therapy to discuss why you feel your traditions are less important or are raised in your family? As far as the cooking goes, tell him he's not welcome to help you if he can't stop picking on you or trying to improve your dishes, and then enforce that boundary." And now we've got those comments out of the way, let's go over to the update to see what it says. So, update. "I'm sorry I haven't responded until now. I really didn't expect to get so much attention to this. So my husband is difficult. His autism means he really has a hard time adapting to other people's thoughts in general, and things being different is hard for him. But cooking and food related things is a huge obstacle. It takes him way longer than the average person to come around, usually, but I think he realized he really missed the mark on this one. While I was steaming about this and hiding out in the bedroom to cool down, he went out and bought more ingredients, then made the salsa exactly as I was trying to make it originally. He understands this doesn't make what he did better, and he was honest and admitted that while he couldn't fully understand why it was important to me, he understands that it is, and he does love me and wants to at least try harder to understand. It was like this with the name thing as well. It took him several weeks or so, but we sat down and talked about it, and he realized that there was no reason I should take his name. He would never consider changing his. No one would expect him to, so it wasn't fair to expect me to do it. We talked more about the salsa thing, and he admitted that part of his defensiveness is when I push my traditions, his brain thinks of it as a rejection of him. He worries when things don't go his way, he thinks they will, and will sometimes shut down, which admittedly for him is taking control inappropriately. He's aware this isn't right and is not my problem to deal with. He promised to just stay out of the kitchen going forward. I know these am I the arseholes don't paint him in the best light, but I do know him. I know he tries, but it takes a lot of patience and time. And I just get frustrated sometimes because it is hard dealing with someone who's on the autism spectrum. It's hard for him to adjust to things, and he forgets that he can't just rationalize logic all his conversations with me. Sometimes he realizes in a few minutes he's being an ass, but often it's much longer and takes several conversations. I appreciate everyone's concerns and advice. Others, who are significant others to people with autism, really help put this into place that it really isn't easy. I promise that while there are admittedly red flags, I will never be with a man long term who refuses to be slash can't be better. This is one reason we haven't had kids yet. He's come a long way from when we met, but I don't think he's quite there, as this situation proves." Now, what would you do if you found yourself in this situation? Let me know your thoughts in the comments below, and we'll move on to the next story. And our next story comes from Outrageous Service 51. "Am I the arsehole for not being excited enough over my sister's pregnancy and saying no to planning the baby shower? Okay, so it's not that I, female 26, hate kids. I really don't, but you'd think that if you spoke to my family. My parents and the rest of my family are going insane over my sister's, Sophia's, pregnancy. It's dominating every discussion and every family get-together. Won't lie, this has been getting to me. Like, I'm not saying it's not a blessing, but oh my god, I'm bored of talking about baby showers, baby names, clothes, etc. So I just kind of turn off when it comes up now. I'm trying to be polite, but it's especially upsetting because the father of my future nephew and niece is the guy I was, and might still be, I don't know anymore, really in love with. Luke was actually someone I dated first, back in my final year of university. Luke is also from my home city too, but we hadn't met prior. We dated a good few months before he decided that we were better as friends. This hurt, but I pushed through it, and we got a good friendship out of it. So when we graduated, we both went back home, and he spent pretty much the entire summer at ours because he has a difficult relationship with his father. That's when Luke and Sophia got together. Yet despite all this history between Luke and I, no one in my family seems to think of this whole experience might be a little strange for me. I won't lie, when I saw him kissing my sister drunk at a party, I kind of thought, you dick. But it's okay, it won't last. Safe to say it lasted, but whatever. You know, you have to get over stuff like this, and I am, but I'm not a fountain of enthusiasm over it either. The drama comes when my mum asked me if I could plan the baby shower, and I told her no, basically because I personally disagree with them trying to hold one during a pandemic anyway, that I have a life outside this whole thing and I'm busy. I didn't say it, but it also feels weird for me to be so involved with my feelings being the mess that they are. I just told her she could do it if she wanted, it's her grandchild, and that makes more sense than me doing it. But my mum got upset with me and my tone and accused me of being unsupportive of my sister's happiness this whole time, and even selfish for not wanting to be a part of it more. And I wasn't going to take that, because I've tried really hard to be mature over this, and I told her she was being suffocating with it. Not everyone has to do everything she wants all the time, and basically told her off for making a drama out of nothing. But now she's upset with me, and I'm starting to feel bad. Am I the arsehole? I gotta say, not the arsehole. I think OP in this one sounds incredibly mature in the way that they're dealing with things. They know that they possibly, feelings still may be there, and it's not good to get involved in that situation while those feelings are there. You don't have to explain your feelings to everyone. And I sort of wonder what was going through my mind when I was reading about your mum trying to push this on you. Has she seen you like maybe stepping back and doesn't know the full situation? Again, not that you have to explain it to her, but I'm just trying to think, why is she trying to push this onto you? It doesn't make much sense to me other than she's trying to involve you because maybe you're stepping back away from your sister and she can see this divide happening of some sort. I don't know. You're definitely not the arsehole for not wanting to do it. You wouldn't be the arsehole for in any situation where you didn't want to do someone's baby shower. It's that simple to me. But let's check out some comments to see what they say. And we'll start with Quick Appointment 82, who says, not the arsehole. This has nothing to do with your history with Luke. If you don't want to do the baby shower, don't do it. Your mum is being extremely entitled to think she can just give commands like that and commit emotional blackmail when people refuse. Mums have the reputation of being so kind and supportive, but I've mostly noticed they tend to be entitled little children that always have to get their way. So strange. And Dan Dutchman says, not the arsehole. Despite the fact that your sister found it appropriate to get together with your ex, you just don't want to plan the baby shower, and that's fine. You have a job and life outside of hers. Yours doesn't have to stop because she is having a baby. If it makes you uncomfortable, then end the story, no need to explain further. And Featherfall101 says, I'm going to say not the arsehole, and I don't think you would be even if your sister wasn't dating your ex. Did anyone in your family know you were together? If so, did anyone in your family ask how you were feeling when they hooked up initially? Did your sister ask how you felt at all? You can't help how you feel about someone slash something than any more than anyone else can, but you can help how you act on those feelings. Then quotes, we dated a good few months before he decided that we worked better as friends. This hurt, but I pushed through it, and we got a good friendship out of it. So when we graduated, we both went back home, and he spent pretty much the entire summer at ours because he has a difficult relationship with his father. That's when Luke and Sophia got together. Then continues to say, you basically never had time to grieve your relationship or get over your feelings from him because he was a constant presence in your life. Your ex is an arsehole for hooking up with your sister, and if your sister knew you dated and never once asked how you felt about it, then she's an arsehole too. I think you're doing exactly as you need to do, distancing yourself from your sister and ex until you're in a better headspace. If you wanted to, you can still support your sister by getting her baby-related things, clothes, toys, nappies, diapers, etc. But if people are pressing you to be more excited or talking about it non-stop, even though you're uncomfortable, you're well within your rights to change the subject or remove yourself entirely if necessary. Now, what would you do if you found yourself in this situation? Let me know in the comments below, and we'll move on to another story. And our next story comes from FastManner8680. Am I the arsehole for not disclosing to my coworkers that I understand them? Hello, I will try to keep this brief. I'm not American, but I've been in America for the past year and a half or so, schooling and picked up a part-time job. At my job, there is a high population of Mexican coworkers, and they frequently speak Spanish to one another. I'm from Peru and also speak Spanish, although they are not really the same, and some of the slang falls off with me. I have very light skin and I am white passing with maybe a slight tan to most people that do not know me. I do have an accent and don't try to hide it, but I guess not many people in America know of the Peruvian accent, and so they ask where I am from. My coworkers have been saying extremely nasty things about myself and other non-Spanish speaking workers, but I chose not to say anything because I do not care for their opinions. The issues came up earlier this week when two co-workers were talking about their relationship. One was the manager of our store and the other was just a worker. They were talking about it so openly in Spanish that I thought everybody in the store knew. That is why when the owner visited and asked me how I was adjusting, I told him the truth. I thought that was an alright place, although some of the not well hidden hostility and dirty comments they made to one another were inappropriate to me. He got angry and confronted the manager, and she got angry at me. I don't know exactly what happened after, but I believe she may be subject to firing because of it all. I talked to my other supervisor, and the owner had made a mistake and told the staff that I was from Brazil, not Peru, so they believed that I did not know Spanish or what they were saying in detail. Since that, most of my coworkers have come to me asking what the Mexican staff has said about them, and the Mexican staff have avoided me. One in particular, though, has been insulting me by calling me a word that I read the meaning, but I'm not going to say it just in case, as well as other things. I called my family to tell them what happened, and my mother told me I was disrespectful by eavesdropping on conversations not meant for me. Am I in the wrong? Hell no, you're not in the wrong. These people were being openly, disgustingly rude about people, their co-workers, and they got called out for it. It's that simple. No one should have to put up with bullying behavior if they're trying to be discreet about it or not. It's still bullying behavior in the workplace. You did totally the right thing. And I'd even report that other person to HR as soon as possible because they're still being bloody rude to you. So report them. But Carskepelis says, not the asshole. You weren't sneaking up and listening around the corner. You wasn't dropping no eaves. And Evermiss says, not the asshole. They chose to talk about their co-workers and make inappropriate comments. Language barriers don't give them the excuse to be shitty people. And Kufat says, not the arsehole, also worth noting that if you had been from Brazil, Spanish and Portuguese are close enough that you'd probably be able to tell that they were talking shit about you. The co-workers are not exactly geniuses here. And Watt says, not the arsehole, I don't understand why your mum is blaming you. Like, no, eavesdropping isn't right, but you literally cannot listen if they're doing it right in front of you. That's on them. An outside question says, not the arsehole. If you say something in public, you have to assume others will hear and understand it. Never say something around others you wouldn't want them to know, because you can never be sure they can't understand you. And one more from Doom Shroomica saying, that's hilarious. I live in a place where Punjabi speakers are often talking shit about everyone around them. Though they're so obvious about it, you don't even have to speak the language to notice. It's super rude and disrespectful to abuse language like that. Language is supposed to bring us together, not separate us. You did the right thing, and they're only mad because they're the assholes. Now, have you ever had a similar situation happen to you before? Let me know in the comments below and your verdicts on all of today's stories if you choose to share them. Never any pressure though, there's never any pressure here, this is the chill zone. Thank you so much for being here today and spending 20 minutes of your precious time with me. Listen to a story or two, it means the absolute world. You are absolute legends for what you do. Thank you so much, and I will see you in the next one. Much love, guys.